DeGray Lake near Arkadelphia has experienced the highs and lows of aquatic vegetation. But if a new project by the Arkansas Game and Fish Commission takes root, the popular fishing lake may be seeing a return to its salad days. Game and Fish has been cultivating water gardens, growing several species of aquatic plants and placing them in the lake in an effort to re-establish natural colonies and improve fish habitat.
The whole reason why we're planting aquatic vegetation in the first place is because once upon a time there was a lot of aquatic vegetation in DeGray, and that contributed to the health of a lot of different fish species. Now around 2010 we saw a pretty drastic decline in the amount of aquatic vegetation in the lake, and that had a detrimental effect on a lot of the different fish species. So one of the best things that we can do for the health of the Lake DeGray fishery as a whole is try to reestablish aquatic vegetation, which not only serves extremely important roles for fish when they're juveniles, but also later stages in their lives. What we did was we contacted the Corps of Engineers that has specialists, and we had them come to DeGray, and we developed a plan that would give us the best shot of reestablishing aquatic vegetation. Now, one of the big issues that we run into is these large shifts in lake level elevation. So we could go and plant a bunch of aquatic vegetation and we could have a major rain event that brings the lake level up, which is gonna kill all of our brood plants, or that lake could drop out, which is gonna leave all of our aquatic vegetation high and dry on the bank. And so we came up with kind of a creative idea. It's a modification of what the Corps has already done. They've got these structures called tetrahedrons, and they're basically these floating triangular looking things. And so we slightly modified those into cubes. And so we fill those with aquatic vegetation and they float, so that protects the plants from major changes in lake level elevation. And with that fencing around the outside, it protects them from predators. So the whole process here of what we're doing is we've got two large greenhouses located at the DeGray Project office. And over the last year, we've been growing multiple species of aquatic vegetation. Now around this time of year, we're moving them out into the lake and we're putting them in these floating enclosures. Now what they'll do is they'll grow in these floating enclosures and they'll start to spring little sprigs and seeds and fragments all over the place and get those little areas established.
Deploy. So what we're seeing just from the surface is an expansion in emergent vegetation on the lower end of DeGray. And what we're seeing a lot of is this here. So this is a flat that's about 2 to 4 or so feet deep. And what you're starting to see more of is emergent water willow and in some places alligator weed starting to sprout up out of the water. Over the past 2 to 3 years, we're seeing a big expansion in the growth of coontail, pondweed, some of the naiad species, hydrilla, egeria, and this is exciting stuff. This is what we're looking for, these tall stands of vegetation that are fairly new to DeGray.
We're putting more emphasis on coontail than any other species. Back when DeGray first got heavily vegetated, for a long period of time, it was primarily coontail. We know coontail works, it creates phenomenal fish habitat. It's just a matter of trying to get some seed out there and what it do, what it's gonna do naturally. The other species are American pondweed, sago pondweed, and eelgrass. So in a situation like this, I think the worst thing you can do is just keep trying when it's not working. So we're gonna give it our all for about 8 years, and if we're not seeing any positive results, then we're gonna hit the drawing board and probably try something different.